Drones have become one of the most influential technologies on a modern battlefield. The cheap drones like commercial quadcopters dropping grenades have become a grave threat. These small, inexpensive, and mass-produced systems have managed to cripple even main battle tanks on many occasions in Ukraine. Faced with waves of low-cost drones and loitering munitions, defense companies are reconsidering the classic model of expensive, sensor-heavy interceptors. The Kreuger 100, developed in Sweden, embodies a different choice. Push the sensing and decision-making into networks and software, and make the interceptor itself cheap, simple, and mass-producible. The result is a small, battery-powered kinetic round designed to be launched in numbers from portable tubes or vehicle pods, offering an affordable hard-kill layer for both civilian and military users. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Kreuger 100 could be the answer to cheap drone menace. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. To counter swarms of cheap UAS, the solution need to be suitable for mass production and be relatively inexpensive. Rather than packing high-end seekers and multi-sensor suites into every interceptor, Kreuger's architecture centralizes the hard tasks: detection, tracking, target discrimination, and engagement planning in ground or vehicle-based systems. Individual rounds carry minimal onboard electronics and rely on data links and software-defined flight control to follow guidance. That trade-off greatly reduces per-unit hardware cost and allows operators to accept expendability, throw quantity at a swarm instead of spending a premium on each shot. A low-cost kinetic round changes how defenders engage. Instead of rationing a handful of expensive interceptors, forces can accept higher expenditure rates and rely on salvo tactics to increase the chance of a kill. Centralized software enables coordinated engagements. Multiple rounds can be queued in time to converge from different vectors, increasing hit probability without driving up individual unit costs. This model is particularly attractive where adversaries use cheap consumer drones or small loitering munitions in swarms or saturation attacks. The Kreuger 100 is developed by a Stockholm startup, Nordic Air Defense. In November 2024, Nordic Air Defense announced that it had secured a 1.2 million euro investment to accelerate research, development, and airborne testing of its Kreuger 100 drone interceptor platform. Kreuger adopts compact propulsion and a flight control philosophy optimized for short, decisive burns rather than continuous high-thrust flight. Using brief high-impulse bursts conserves energy overall and enables a smaller power source to produce the accelerations needed for interception. The aerodynamic surfaces are simple but responsive, with rapid attitude adjustments used to shape intercept trajectories. This approach removes the need for heavy vectored thrust systems while preserving enough maneuverability to achieve hit-to-kill or close proximity intercepts against small agile drones. A central element of the concept is flexible guidance. Kreuger supports multiple operational modes, wholly reliant on command guidance from a local sensor stack and C2 node, lightly autonomous with inexpensive IR or EO seekers for terminal homing, or pre-programmed flight patterns intended to be used in conjunction with external tracking. By making autonomy optional, the system lets buyers decide where to sit on the cost versus resilience curve. Full reliance on an external sensor and data link yields cheaper rounds, but it also introduces dependence on secure communications and on the availability and quality of the sensor network. Kreuger is intended to be modular. Single-tube handheld launchers, reloadable pods for vehicles, and multi-shot dispensers for fixed-site defense are all part of the envisioned ecosystem. Using battery power simplifies handling compared with traditional rocket motors and opens up safer storage and transport options. But it also shifts the engineering focus to high-power battery design, thermal management, and safe magazine configurations. The logistics picture emphasizes large magazines and quick reloads. When interceptors are inexpensive, operators can adopt an aggressive salvoing doctrine to defeat mass threats. The Kreuger 100 is flexible, allowing for mission-specific payloads and launcher configurations adapted to the operational environment. Kreuger-like interceptors are best seen as one element in a layered CUAS architecture. Non-kinetic options, such as directed energy, lasers, or high-power microwaves, can offer very low marginal cost per engagement and are attractive for massed or persistent swarm defeat, but they demand significant power and thermal capacity. Conversely, networked kinetic rounds provide a tangible hard kill capability that is relatively simple to field and integrate. In practice, a mixed set of tools, electronic warfare to deny or disrupt navigation, directed energy for mass suppression, and expendable kinetic rounds for final defeat, offers the most resilient posture. In May 2021, a month after an explosives-laden drone targeted U.S. forces at an Iraq base, the top American commander for the Middle East stated that finding better ways to counter such attacks is a top priority, and the United States is still behind the curve on solutions. Marine General Frank McKenzie told reporters traveling with him that the use of small drones by Iranian-backed militia is only going to grow in the next few years. McKenzie said the U.S. must find more ways to counter their use by America's enemies in the Middle East and elsewhere. He had stated, "We're working very hard to find technical fixes that would allow us to be more effective against drones." Since then, many advancements have been made in EW domain, laser weapons as well as kinetic means, with a focus of countering small drones. The collective West has taken note of the threat and several new concepts are coming up. The Kreuger 100 represents a pragmatic pivot in counter-UAS thinking. Accept expendability and move complexity from the projectile into software and networks. That shift aligns procurement and operational logic with the economics of modern drone threats, allowing defenders to buy and employ effects at scale. The logic is simple. Using expensive interceptors to deal with cheap drones is unsustainable. But dependence on external sensors, data links, and battery technologies creates new vulnerabilities that must be actively managed. The ultimate measure of success will be whether such low-cost interceptors can deliver consistently reliable terminal performance and survive in contested electronic and environmental conditions. If they do, they will become a credible and cost-effective building block in layered counter-UAS defense. If this system works as described and can be serial produced, the cost will go down, and this could be very effective counter.